you doing? Listen, I'm working on something interesting, I think, but I need a little time. Anyway, I got a request through the ether, so to speak. Someone's looking for a crew to take a score, but I don't know anymore. Thought maybe you'd be interested. Personally, I wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot barge pole because I don't know any of these people. But if you're interested, be my guest. I can tell them to come see you.
So, Mr. Crest said we should talk about work, but not here. So is there a room in the back or something? Cool, I'll get set up. So, Mr. Crest said you might be able to help me out with something. Well, not me, so that's clear. It's not me you're gonna be helping. And I want it understood that I am not involved. Just a bystander doing a favor. And this is not an offer of employment so much as an opportunity. And, well, anyway, that's just getting a bit technical. But the point is, sometimes our fair and legal justice system makes mistakes. And this is one such time. Here he is, Professor Maxim Rashkovsky. You know the professor? Used to be head of research for the Army. 3 doctorates. Overconfident polymath, vain sociopath, tedious egomaniac, control freak, geneticist, weapons development, engineer, car nut, but definitely not a people person. Accused of espionage along with everything else? You don't remember? Well, lucky you. Exceedingly vain and self-absorbed man, brilliant at everything he does, yada yada yada, makes you want to puke. He's a goddamn traitor. I mean, he's a rat, but he pays. Incarcerated for a crime he did commit, but, well, let's just say money talks and he's going to walk. So, we got a few things to get ready, all pretty straightforward. Do them one at a time, but any way you like. Standard op for a gov fact breakout, if you know what I mean. Rad. All right, first thing's a plane. Then we got a bus, and then, well, 2 things. We got the inmate transfer schedule and Rashkovsky's car. More on that later. Let me show you. We need a plane to get the professor out of the country. It's currently being used to traffic drugs by transnational street gang, the Vagos. The bus. We need a standard Bolingbrook transport vehicle. The least traffic is on the route from Polito Bay. All right? That's where you're going to be able to get a hold of one. You can get a hard copy of the inmate transit schedule at the LSPD's Mission Row station. Go in unarmed. Play it cool. You might not have a problem. That's a 2-person job, max. The other 2-hander is our guy's prize casco. We believe it's about to be shipped to Korea by a luxury car theft ring. Okay. Mr. Crest said you guys are at least semi-competent, so, well, Professor Rashkovsky pays well.
logistics are as yet undecided. Go in how you like, but go in with a good supply of ammunition, armor, and maybe even explosives. It's gonna get kinda heavy. Like I said before, the airfield is under Vagos control. They're using the plane to make trafficking runs across the border. That means it's already set up to take Rashkovsky out of the country. Limited radar visibility, plausible cover story. It's perfect. Don't let the fact that there are a bunch of angry drug dealers waiting for you affect how you go in, or actually do. Air traffic's telling me you're airborne. Bring it to the airport and you're done. The rest of the team's going to clean up the Vagos. Pilot, come in. Is there any cargo on the plane? Drugs? Guns? Wild animals? I guess if you're flying, you haven't been charged by a coked-up crash of rhinos. You know, last week, three customs officers died from spider bites after opening a Marabunta Grande shipment of untaxed coca-bola wood. What lesson can you take from this? It ain't the size of the dog in the fight, it's the amount and toxicity of the venom in the dog's sack. Unless the dog is really effing big, then you're screwed anyway. So, look out for creepy crawlies, and any drugs on that plane belong to me. Man, I love selling drugs. I am a criminal, after all. My team's waiting at LSIA. Can we hurry this up, please? We need to clean this up quick, so leave the area as soon as you've handed over the plane. Touchdown at LSIA, the happier everyone will be.
Up. We'll take care of this.
I didn't know we still had this.
There we are, all yours. As you can see, I run a very tight ship. For everyday peace of mind, that gun's hard to beat. Couldn't have picked better myself.
Okay, it's time to catch the bus. You can have that. It's on the road from the prison to Polito, and I'm here if you need me.
Yeah.
I know what you're thinking. You're thinking it'd be easier to take an old school bus, paint it, bar the windows, and make it smell like blood, bowels, and your brother's high school tube sock. Sure, we could do that, but it costs money, and this is costing us... is costing Rashkovsky enough already. So, you're hitting the transport, and you're not second-guessing us again. Sandy Shores. One of my people look after it till we go in. How's the bus? No one hiding in the back with a cell phone, a carton of cigarettes, a pint of Pruno up his ass?
We'll hold on to this for you.
two teams. Split up and hit your objectives. I'm setting up a healthy atmosphere for competitiveness. Use that. Station team, you're going for the Bolingbroke transit schedule. You've got the right uniforms, but they'll be no good to you if you turn up on foot or in civilian transportation. Get a hold of a cop car using any means necessary. Then you can go to the station, and I shouldn't need to say this. Don't get yourselves killed.
What the? No!
Thank you.
Hey, good work, people. Great job. Nice, we're still in business. Very well done. All of you. Very, very non-incriminating. Yes, that's the word I'm looking for. You know, it's ironic given we, maybe now's not the best time to discuss irony. God, what is wrong with me, you know? I'm usually such a high achiever, you know, for a criminal. So, before we remove Professor Rashkovsky from his unwelcome stay in prison, we've got to clean up a few other loose ends pertaining to the case. Yes, it's a killing, but no, it's nothing immoral at all. Just lawyers. Well, the professor's old business associate and two lawyers, but really it's all the same. I mean, I always say, if you can't kill a couple lawyers to bend the law to your will, then who can you kill, right? Oh, here they are. Gavin Van De Loop and Josh Sherman. Get them on the way to City Hall. Get the documents they're carrying. The business partner is Dima Popov. Extremely rich, extremely paranoid, and extremely horrible. Don't cry for this guy. No one else will. He's renting a place up in Richmond Glen. Just him. And a huge security team. Get close to him, take him down, and after that, we should be ready to go.
Now. It's a two-horse race with two of you in each horse, the ass and the head. Horse one is going for the lawyers at City Hall. Horse two is on the business partner in Richmond. Sound good? Get moving. Horse one, there's a ladder going up to the roof of the building opposite City Hall. You've got your long-range rifles, right? You want to minimize risk of failure, so you're taking your kills at exactly the same time. Coordinate your shots.
Just cleaned up at Popov's house. Bring the deposition back here.
Got a bit of a problem. Some asshole got wind of what we were up to. Apparently, killing a guy's closest associate puts a bit of a spotlight on him. Anyway, now I'm told they put a price on the professor's head, so we gotta move. Now, is that clear? Can we get going? All right. And remember, the professor's paying you, not me. Not me at all. So keep him alive. Based on this inmate transfer schedule, Bolingbroke are expecting a new arrival. One of you is going to intercept the transport, make sure it doesn't get there. Two of you are going to be taking our prison bus and making your way into the facility in its place. You'll be playing inmate and guard. Stay in character as long as it's useful, then make your way to the rooftops. I'll get on the radio and give you a path to the prof. Meanwhile, the pilot will have picked up the plane and be waiting on the evac in the air. Whoever stole the bus will be bypassing the prison and torching it somewhere discreet. After that, it's just a matter of getting your guy out of the clink and getting him onto the plane. Everyone flies out of there except for the bus thief. Professor Rashkovsky takes control of the plane. The three of you on board take a jump. The professor's out of U.S. airspace and reunited with his precious car. Simple. Should be the easiest money you'll ever make. Speak soon.
Just one, huh? But the drug laws are keeping us full. Come on.
Okay, get to it. As long as they think you're an inmate and a guard, they shouldn't raise the alarm. Shouldn't.
I thought they were sending professionals. I collaborate and nearly get a ship for their pleasure. Just give me... Nice. There are some screws I hope we run into. Let's go!
Clear the area, then rush. whiskey out of the country quickly and in good health. The better you do those things, the better you're paid.
But this is what you pay for.
Remember, a scratch on Rashkovsky is a scratch off your paychecks. And the quicker you get them out, the more you're paid for it.
I don't like you.
Choose a place to land and pull them out of there. I should say, I've been impressed by your professionalism. I'm not gonna go into it, but Rashkovsky's part of something bigger. Way bigger. I need to make a few more inquiries, and we'll be ready to go on a job that requires your particular skill set. Don't retire on me just yet.
That wasn't you, was it? Bolingbroke? You know how I said I didn't want to touch that job with a 10-foot barge pole? Well, if I'd known what it was going to be, I would have told you I didn't want to touch anyone who touched it with a 10-foot barge pole. It's too late now, isn't it? Things are pretty quiet right now. Those people, and me too. That's not to say there won't be something down the line,